Hello students, today's our topic is methods for removing temporary hardness of water. Okay, already we came to know hard water and soft water, and that in that we discuss temporary hardness of water and permanent hardness of water. Now let us discuss how to remove temporary hardness of water. In that we have the two methods. First one is what? Boiling. Okay, so boiling, what happened during the soluble here? Soluble magnesium bicarbonate is converted into what? Insoluble magnesium hydroxide, and calcium bicarbonate is converted to what? Insoluble calcium carbonate. Okay, so what happened, as you know very well, if it is a insoluble, you can separate easily. So in the water, soluble what we have? Magnesium hydroxide and magnesium bicarbonate and calcium bicarbonate is what? In the soluble form. They are converted into what? Insoluble magnesium hydroxide in case of magnesium bicarbonate. It is converted into calcium carbonate in case of calcium hydroxide. So once you got the what? Insoluble, nothing but precipitate, you can go for easily filtration. Then you can obtain what? Soft water. Okay, so you are going to get the soft water. Let us see the equations. So here one thing you have to remember, what is the meaning of soft water means? The process of removal of calcium and magnesium ions. Okay, as we discussed, we have the cations and anions in the what? Hard and soft water. So if you come to now here, we have the cation, what we have? Calcium ion and magnesium ion. Okay, this we have the cations. So if you remove the only cations, okay, so that is called what? That water is called what? Soft water, or softening of water. Here if you see in the equation, what happened? Magnesium bicarbonate, okay, on going for the heating, it is converted into magnesium hydroxide. It is in soluble form. Now magnesium hydroxide what? Insoluble. So once it is insoluble means what happened? You are going to precipitate, right? So you are going to separate easily. Next, what we have? Calcium bicarbonate. Okay, so this calcium bicarbonate, if you heat, it's going to precipitate as a what? Calcium. So this is a calcium carbonate, not the bicarbonate. Make it correction here in the notes also. So it is a what? Calcium carbonate. It is in the insoluble. So once it is insoluble, it means you are going to get the precipitate. You can separate easily. Here we have the downward arrow. Downward arrow indicate what? It is a precipitate. Okay, so now what you are doing here, simply you are going to remove the cations. Okay, we are not going to remove the anions. So here calcium is going to remove, so you are going to get the what? Soft water. Next, what we have? Klux method. Okay, another method for removal of temporary hardness of water. What we have? Klux method. Okay, in this method, what you are going to add? You are going to add the lime, nothing but calcium hydroxide, to the what? Hard water. So what is the reaction here? So it precipitates out calcium carbonate, magnesium hydroxide, so which is going to be filtered. So now let us see the equation here. So this is in the hard water, we have the calcium bicarbonate, magnesium bicarbonate in the soluble form. Okay, now you are going to add the lime, nothing but calcium hydroxide. So now if you see the reaction, what happened is here, now calcium bicarbonate is precipitated as a calcium carbonate, and it is in the insoluble form. Simply what you are doing, soluble bicarbonates are converted into insoluble carbonates. In case of magnesium hydroxide, what happened? In a reaction with the lime, you are going to get the calcium carbonate and magnesium hydroxide together. Again here both are what? Insoluble form. Once it is insoluble means you can separate easily. So these are the two methods for the removal of what? Temporary hardness of water.